I'm in a Renault Zoe here, and this has got the dreaded check electrical system error up there on the dash. So in this video, I'm going to look at the common causes of this and how you can resolve it. So it's quite common on the Zoe for it to throw an error message like this. And you can get this one, or you can get motor failure. There's only so many error messages it throws. So a lot of time, the fault that the car has got isn't anywhere near as bad as the error message sort of indicates. And a lot of people assume there's something majorly wrong with a car and will book it into a Renault dealer. But quite often it's something that you can sort yourself. And majority of the time, it's simply a low 12-volt battery. However, that's not always the case, and I'll go through a few of the things that you can check in this video. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle-related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. The most common reason for errors on a Zoe by far is caused by the 12-volt battery. So what you need to do is test your 12-volt battery. I've got a little battery tester here, but you could use a multimeter and just simply measure the voltage. But the mistake a lot of people do is measure the voltage when the vehicle is live, and in this case we can see it's 13.5 volts. So that isn't measuring the actual voltage of the battery, that's measuring the voltage of the charging unit, because all of the time the vehicle is on, it is charging this battery. So on a Renault Zoe, as soon as you open the doors, even before the vehicle's on, the charging circuit starts. So to measure your battery, you want to have the vehicle off with the bonnet open, and the vehicle's got to be off for 2 or 3 minutes beforehand, and ideally leave it for half an hour or so, because when the battery has been charged for a little bit, it's going to give you a sort of a false result because it's had a little bit of a charge. So leave the bonnet open, shut the vehicle down, leave it for half an hour at least, come back to it and then measure the voltage. And a battery should be 12.5 volts, and while it's charging is about 13 to 14 volts. If that battery drops below about 10 volts, that's sort of the level where it starts throwing errors in the ECUs in the vehicle, and then potentially you get that electrical fault error there on the dash. And if your 12-volt battery is low, then there's a couple of things you can do. You could replace it and drop in a brand new battery, or you could charge it with a mains charger, and I've done plenty of other videos on the channel about that. Just search for battery and you'll find those videos. So I've got another Renault Zoe here, and this vehicle has been turned off for a little while, so let's look at the battery on this one. It's obviously not making decent contact because we're only seeing a very small voltage there, and this is measuring 12.67 volts. So that battery looks fine in this car. So in this Zoe, as you can see, we've got the check electric system error up. And I've scanned it with my scanner, and it's obvious in this case this was due to the 12-volt battery going low. And that's because this car's been sat here unused for a period of time. And there's errors in the ECUs about 12-volt battery voltages and CAN communication errors. So what I'll be able to do here is just to go through, delete all the errors, because this 12-volt battery has had a bit of a charge, and that will then clear. Let's just do that and I can show you that in practice. So I'm doing a quick erase. It's going to go through every ECU, erase all the fault codes. It's just doing the final two now, and already the error's gone. Another cause for that check electric system on the dashboard in a Zoe is actually mice. It's quite common for mice or rodents to get up into the engine compartment or motor compartment in an electric vehicle, and then they chew on wires. So have a look around the motor stack and look for mice droppings. You will often see in cavities around the aluminium here, you might find a few mice droppings, and if that's the case, then you need to go hunting for chewed up wires. And also check your fuse box, check for water ingress, and check all of the wiring looms in and out of that and all across the car. Look for chew marks and damage on any PVC cables, because the mice like to eat the PVC. So another reason for that error on a Zoe is actually the water pump, and this is what's prompted me to make this video, because a couple of days ago I went out to see a customer Zoe. It's a Zoe we sold them, I don't know, probably 4 years ago or so now, and they were getting this check electric error up. So I went out there, and what I found in their case is it was caused by the water pump. So obviously you can't do much about this if you don't have a diagnostic scanner, or you don't have an ODB2 dongle and an app to look at the codes. But anyway, in the Zoe, a lot of the modules, the ECUs, have three letter acronyms, and the one that I was interested in is the EVC. And EVC actually stands for Electric Vehicle Computer, which is a silly name, but anyway, that's the motor ECU basically. And then in here, it is monitoring the water pump. So I'll bring up a shot of the error I was getting on their car, because I don't think I'm going to see it on this. No, I'm not. But on their car, I had an active fault, which was the driving water pump command. So after raising all the faults and trying the car, it was that error that kept coming back time and time again. And on the Zoe, the water pump is down the front here somewhere, but it's not really visible. But what you can do with the scanner is you can go into special functions and you can activate the water pump. So I did that, and with the cap off, I could then see the surface of the water rippling, and I could tell coolant was being circulated around the system. So you could tell the water pump was working fine, and I could hear it in action and hear it cutting in and out. And on the Renault Zoe vehicles, the ECU measures the revolutions of that water pump, and it's all stored within the ECU. So I'm in the EVC here, and I can go to special function, and you should be able to see a counter. In this case, I can't. For some reason, some Zoes I can see it, some I can't. I don't know whether I'm on old software, because I am running very old software on this scanner. But on this particular car, I do not have the function to read the counter. But anyway, this other customer's car that I was working on a few days ago, I could. And it's exactly the same model and the same age as this Zoe. So this is an issue which you will encounter on older Zoes. And that counter clocks up to a very high number in the tens of thousands of revolutions. I don't know what the magic number is, but at some point that will then throw up an error. And it gets to this particular number, whatever that is, and then throws up the error, and then you get that electrical fault up there on the dash. So in this case, all I did was went into the special functions, and I had a function here, and I reset the counter to zero. And effectively, you're telling the car that you fitted a new water pump. And straight away, the error went, the car was happy, and I tested it, and it was completely happy. So that's something else you've got to bear in mind, that when a Zoe gets to a certain age, that number of revolutions is going to get to that magic number where it thinks it's an error, and you basically have either got to change the water pump or reset it back to zero. So that water pump is probably a plastic pump, and obviously, like everything mechanical, has a lifespan, and Renault have obviously incorporated that into the ECU. And that number, whatever that is, I don't know what it is, once that water pump has reached that number of revolutions, it then throws the error in the car, and then normally the customer would take that car into a Renault dealer, and they would then probably change that water pump. I suspect after spending quite a few £100 on diagnostic fees as well. But in this case, I did test the water pump first, and it was moving the water around the cooler system just fine. So it was just a case of resetting that counter, goes back to naught, and everything is then working just fine. But obviously, a water pump does have a moving part, but at some point in the future, that will wear out and need replacing. But there's no point doing it just when it hits that magical number, whatever that is. And when that does eventually fail, then it's going to stop the water moving around the system. It's going to throw errors anyway, so you replace it when it breaks, not just because it's reached this number of revolutions. So I have another Zoe here of exactly the same age. It's a 2014 as the one I was fixing the other day, and this is a Q motor, the same, and it's also the same as the one next to it as well. This one is error free, but let's just see whether I can see the water pump information on this one. So already this has got different information under the EVC. So this is where I could activate the water pump. And under here I can toggle the water pump on and off. And that's what I was doing to test whether it was still working by watching the coolant in the reservoir bottle. And then under special function, this is where we've got driving water pump aging counter, which it's strange the 2015 car next to me doesn't have it. And there we go. This has got the number of revolutions that the water pump has done in this vehicle, which is, I've got to put some commas in here, so that's one there. So that's 200, no, that's in the millions, isn't it? Anyway, there's the number. I can hardly see it without my glasses, but it's a hell of a lot. Is that 2.6 million, I think? On the car I was looking at the other day, this was saying not available, like it's saying there. I couldn't see that number. I have a feeling, because the other car had thrown the error message, I have a feeling when this gets too big, it just goes to not available, and then it throws up the electrical error up there. So in this case, I just went in, because it was a 2014 car, I went into a raise. I erased the water pump counter, and straight away that number changed from not available to naught. And then within the 2 minutes I was looking at it, it went to 30, counted it, and went to 81 in about 2 minutes. So it proved that it had reset the counter. The counter was then starting to clock up, and straight away the error went. So this is something you need to look at if your Zoe has got the error, and you need to have a look to see whether it's got this water pump counter, and if needed, just reset that, and it's a cheap and easy fix. Actually, let's just do it on this vehicle. So driving water pump, okay, press OK to activate. Oh no, that's activating the water pump. There we go. That had erased it at the same time. So now we haven't got that huge number. It's now done 15 revolutions. So anyway, that will do for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you have, please do click thumbs up, that really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. If you want to know more about the Renault Zoe, there'll be a link below in the video description to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made. Okie doke, I'll see you on the next one.